Hello friends, welcome back to the second video of unit number 3. In the last video, we see the definition of center of gravity, center of mass and centroid, as well as we see the standard distances of a CG point for the standard plane laminars like rectangle, right angle, triangle, circle, semicircle, quarter circle and so on. Now in today's video, we are solving some of the numericals to locate the center of gravity point for some composite plane figures. So let's see the first problem. Locate the centroid of the plane area as shown in figure. So here a figure is given. O is the origin, and here one figure of having some irregular shape is provided, and also the dimensions of that plane lamina is also given. And we have to determine the center of gravity point of this complete plane lamina with respect to this origin O. Now to solve this problem, we know that we are dividing a whole figure into small sections and then compiling all the sections. Further, we are determining the value of x bar. So in the same way, here I draw this vertical line over here, and the complete plane lamina is divided into two parts. That is, this is the first right angle triangle, and the second part is this rectangle. And now this is the CG point of the first right angle triangle, and the location of this from the given origin O is x1 and y1. Similarly, this is the CG point of the second rectangle figure, and from origin O the distance is given as x2 and y2. This will be x2 and the y2. So now consider to find out the center of gravity. Here considering the first section, right angle triangle, where the CG point of this individual lamina is over here, and the from given origin O the distance of this CG point is given as x1 and the y1. So area is determined as half or base into height. So base is 60, height is 75, so this is the area 2250 mm². Then x bar and y bar distances. So from the figure, and as we have discussed in the earlier video, that with respect to this corner origin O, the CG distance, if it is a corner point, then in that case the CG distance is marked as a 2/3, as we are considering this as a corner point. So from corner point, the CG is located at a distance of 2/3 of the total distance. So total distance is given as a 60, and 2/3 of that is nothing but the 40. Now similarly, y bar distance. So now in case of y bar, it is from this 90-degree side. So from 90-degree side, the distance of CG point is equal to 1/3 of the total. So total is 75, and 1/3 of that is nothing but the 25. Now in the next column, we are making this A into x bar. So area 2250 into 40, it is 90,000. Then similarly, 2250 into this 25, that is A into y bar, is 56,250. Now similarly, for the second shape, a rectangle, and this will be the triangle. Now here we are considering this second shape only, that's why this triangle, by which we have discussed in the earlier case, is marked as a dotted line. So with respect to origin O, the distance of CG is marked as a x2, and here the distance is y2. So area of rectangle is 105 into 75, the dimensions. Then x bar is equals to, now we know that if it is a only a rectangle, that is if the CG will be like this, forget about this portion, if the our O is located over here, then in that case this CG distance is equal to A by 2 and B by 2, that is nothing but this will be equals to 105 by 2, right, and the vertical distance is 75 by 2. Now here, but our origin O is not at this point, origin O is located somewhere here. Therefore, the total x distance is equals to this 60 plus 105 by 2, which is marked over here as 60 plus 105 divided by 2, which is nothing but 112.5. And here the vertical distance with respect to this origin O or with respect to this origin O, the vertical distance will remain same. It is nothing but 75 by 2, that is equals to 37.5. So now again taking the A into X bar, 7875 into 112.5 as 885937.5 and 7875 into 37.5, that is 295.32.5. Now taking the summation of this area column 2250 plus 785, then taking the summation of A into X bar column and summation of A into Y bar column, to locate this X bar equals to X bar equal to A1 X1 plus A2 X2. As our figure is divided into only two shapes, therefore here A1 X1 plus A2 X2 divided by A1 plus A2. As we have seen in the earlier video, that integration of X into dA. So here A is A1 into corresponding CG distance X1, then A2 into corresponding CG distance is X2. Likewise, all the small parts get added over here and divided by the total area A, that is nothing but A1 plus A2. So substituting the values of A1 X1, which we already make the summation over here, summation of this column of A into X bar is 9.759 into 10 raised to 5. Substituting the value over here divided by total area, we get the X bar as a 96.38 and Y bar A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 divided by A1 plus A2. So summation of this last column A into Y bar divided by summation of A column, we get the Y bar distance as 34.71. It means that from this CG of complete lamina or the irregular lamina given is located at a distance of this X bar final and the Y bar, and this X bar and Y bar distances are nothing but 96.38 and 34.71 mm. Now let's solve the second problem. Locate the centroid of the plane area as shown in figure. All the dimensions are given in mm. Now again here one of the irregular lamina is provided and we have to find out the CG of this complete lamina. Now here let's divide the total lamina into some standard shapes. So I draw over here a dotted line. So this is the first shape, a right angle triangle. Then this will be the second shape, a rectangle. Then this will be the third shape, again a rectangle, and the last fourth shape, a semicircle. And corresponding to these standard shapes, these are the CG points CG1, CG2, CG3 and CG4, and corresponding distances from the origin O, X1, Y1, then X2, Y2, then X3, Y3 and then finally X4, Y4. Now let's see it separately. Here this is the first shape, a right angle triangle, and this will be the distances x1 and y1. So area of triangle is half of base into height. So base is 90, height is 180, total is 8100. Now X bar, so from the 90 degree side, X bar is located at 1/3 position. So 90 divided by 3. But now this lamina is on the opposite side of positive X, therefore its X distance is considered as a minus. Again take a note of this, that the given lamina of right angle triangle is on the opposite side of positive X, therefore its X bar distance is considered as a negative. Then Y bar distance, again from this corner point the distance is considered as a 2/3. So 180 divided by 2/3, that is nothing but 1 20. Sorry, here it is 180 written. 180 into 2/3, that is nothing but the 120. Now again, if you see, this lamina is in the positive y side, therefore y bar distance will remains positive. Now the next column is a into x bar and a into y bar. So just taking the multiplication of this a and x and a and y. Now considering the second shape. So second shape is a rectangle, which is over here. This will be the second shape. Now in second shape, this will be the CG point of the standard shape, and from O the distances will be x2 and y2. Now area of rectangle is 100 into 90, that is 9000. Now again, x distance from the origin O is half of 90, that is 90/2, but again it is in the opposite side of positive x, so therefore this distance is also considered as a negative. Now if our standard rectangular shape is here, then this will be the our origin O. So with respect to this origin O, this is the distance y bar, x bar and y bar, that is 90/2 x bar and 100/2 y bar. But now our origin is at over here, so therefore the y bar distance is equals to this 180 plus this 100/2, that is the total y2 distance. So 180 plus 100/2, 230. So now next is just a into x bar and then a into y bar. Third shape is again the rectangle, and CG of this is located over here and origin is over here. So area of rectangle 150 into 280, x bar distance again 150 divided by 2. Now this x bar y bar is completely located in the positive x and y sides. Both the x bar and y bar are positive, 150/2 and 280/2. Next is a into this x bar, a into this y bar. Now last shape is this semicircle. Here the CG of semicircle is located over here. In standard shapes we are seeing like this, somewhere here this type is there. So origin will be located over here, and from the origin O, this is the y bar distance and this will be the x bar distance. So here y bar distance is the radius r and x bar distance is 4r/3π. But now our origin O is available at this location, so total distance of CG 4 point is this 150 plus 4r/3π. So x bar is equals to 150 plus 4r into 4r/3π. The radius is given as a, the total height is 280, so radius is 140. Then y bar distance is nothing but r, which is nothing but 140. Again this figure is also in the positive x and y side, x and y bar both are positive. Taking a into x bar, a into y bar. Now finally make the summation of column A, summation of column AX bar and summation of column AY bar. And finally therefore X bar equals to summation of A into X bar divided by summation of A. We get X bar as 101.82 and Y bar summation of AY bar divided by summation of A is 150.55. It means for this, the CG point for this complete plane lamina, the CG point is located somewhere over here, where this x bar distance is some 101 and this y z distance is given, that is 150.55. Then the third problem, locate the centroid of the plane area as shown in figure. All dimensions are again provided in m. So this is a plane lamina given. Now again divide this plane lamina into small parts. So first this quarter circle, then second this rectangle, third again rectangle, and fourth is the right angle triangle. And their respective CGs, CG1, CG2, CG3 and CG4. Now from the origin O, the distances of all these x1, here this distance is given, that is y1, then y2, x2, x3, then here y3 and x4, y4. So now in this, considering the first shape, a quarter circle, so area of quarter circle is pi r square divided by 4, radius is given 60, and x and y bar distances are 4r by 3 pi, 4r by 3 pi. Now both the complete quarter circle is in the opposite x and opposite y, therefore x bar and y bar both are negative. Further, a into x bar, a into y bar. Then second, a rectangle, so area of rectangle 40 into 60, x bar distance is 60 by 2, y bar distance is 40 by 2. Now x bar distance is in the opposite of x, so therefore this is minus, and y bar distance is 40 by 2. Further, a into x bar, a into y bar. Now next is third, second rectangle, that is x3 and y3. So here x3 and y3, a1 area of rectangle is 30 into 40, then x bar distance is 30 by 2 and y bar distance is 40 by 2. So here a into x bar, a into y bar. Again, the whole lamina is in the positive quadrant or first quadrant, so both x bar, y bar is positive. We can remember these things by means of a quadrant also, that in which quadrant the lamina is located, in first, second, third or fourth. As in the first quadrant, x, y both will be positive. In the second quadrant, x negative, y positive. In third quadrant, x, y both will be negative. In fourth quadrant, x positive, y negative. So in that way also you can mark the sign conventions for x bar and y bar. Now the fourth shape is located in this fourth quadrant. So here x bar and y bar. So x bar is positive and y bar is negative. So now again here area of triangle half of base into height. Then from 90 degree side, x bar distance is 1/3, again y bar distance is also 1/3, so 30 by 3 and minus 45 by 3. So taking a into x bar, a into y bar. Now finally take the summation of column A, summation of column ax bar and summation of column ay bar, and substituting over here we get x bar as minus 16.78 and y bar as minus 14.22. It means that the for the whole lamina the CG point is located in the third quadrant, that is x bar and y bar, as we are getting both the values negative for whole lamina. So CG of whole lamina is located in the third quadrant. Now similarly, next problem, locate the centroid of the plane area as shown in figure. It is a L shape figure given. Again, dimensions are given in mm. So I take divide it into first rectangle and this horizontal second rectangle, CG1, CG2. So this will be the x1 distance, then y1 distance, x2 and y2. So now again taking x1 first shape, area 100 into 10, then x bar is this 10 divided by 2 and y bar distance is this vertical height plus 100 by 2, that is 15 plus 100 by 2, then a into x bar, a into y bar. Then taking the second rectangle, the bottom rectangle, x bar distance is 100 by 2 and y bar distance is 15 by 2, taking a into x and a into y. Now taking the summation of a column, summation of ax column, summation of ay column, and we locate the x bar as 32 mm and y bar as 30.5 mm. So in this way, any type of composite plane given, we can locate the center of gravity point for the given lamina. Only thing is that we have to divide the given lamina into some standard shapes and then locate their CGs individually, and then finally find out the x bar and y bar. Now while locating this, first thing we have to remember that their x bar and y bar sign conventions, in which quadrant that lamina is located, first, second, third or fourth. With respect to that, we have to mark the sign for x bar and y bar. So In the next video, we are locating the center of gravity point for some shaded area or some more composite plane figures in which the some shaded area is given. That is, from the whole lamina, some of the part is extracted, and for the remaining area, we have to locate the center of gravity. So, let's meet in the next video. For today's video, thank you.